Laplace of t, then Laplace of t cube. Now what is the Laplace of 1? What is the Laplace of 1?
1 upon s.
1 upon s. The Laplace of t?
1 upon s square.
2 upon s square. The Laplace of t cube is the 3 factorial upon s to the power 4, provided s is greater than 0. Right? So in this way, we can apply the linearity property and we can find out the Laplace transform of any function greater than equals to 0. Right? Next, we can find out the Laplace of some standard function e to the power at, where a is any constant. So we can find out the Laplace transform of this. Now by definition, what is the Laplace of ft? This is integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus st into function ki value put ki e to the power at dt. Right? Now we can club these two. We get this is e to the power minus s minus a t dt. You can write this.
Ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, t square ka ma'am 2 factorial upon s cube hoga na?
Square ka?
Yes ma'am.
Yes, 2 factorial upon s cube. Yes, yehi hoga. Yahan pe t tha.
नहीं वो देख
और यहाँ पर t क्यूब है ओके
ओके
नाउ जस्ट सी लैप्लास ऑफ e टू द पावर 80 सो हमने ft की जगह e टू द पावर 80 पुट किया नाउ वी कैन कंबाइन दीस टू हमने ये माइनस क्यू कॉमन लिया बिकॉज़ वी व्हेन वी अप्लाई दीस लिमिट्स वी विल गेट सम कंडीशन दैट फॉर व्हाट वैल्यू ऑफ s दिस इंटीग्रल एग्जिस्ट नाउ व्हाट इज एन इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ दिस इट विल बी e टू द पावर माइनस s माइनस a t upon minus s minus a. This point is clear? Yes, is it clear to all of you? We apply the definition of Laplace. This is the integral, this one. We substitute the value of ft. We can combine these two. Now we will put the limits. So when you put infinity, you get minus infinity. That will be zero. Provided your this number is strictly greater than 0. If it is less than 0, you get minus minus plus infinity. So the integral is not finite, right? So we get a condition that s minus a should be greater than 0. Or you can say s should be greater than a. So for these values of a or for these values of s, this Laplace transform of this function exists. Right? And now what will be the value of this integral? When you put infinity, you get 0. And when you put 0, you get e to the power 0, it is as 1. Minus minus plus. So 1 over s minus a. So the Laplace transform of e to the power at will be what? 1 upon s minus a. Is it clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
So now tell me, what will be the Laplace transform of e to the power 4t? What will be this? Abhi humne kiya Laplace transform of e to the power at is 1 over s minus a provided s is greater than a. Kya aega? This will be 1 upon a kitna hai? 4. This will be 1 upon s minus 4 provided s is greater than 480 using this exponential function. Now, what will be the Laplace transform of e to the power iota at? Kya aega ye? Abhi humne kiya upar.
1 upon s minus iota.
Yes, 1 upon s minus iota. Now we can rationalize this and we can separate the real and imaginary part. Now what will you get? This is s plus iota a divided by s square plus a square. This point is clear? We use this formula and we get the Laplace transform of e to the power iota at will be 1 upon s minus this number. this number is iota I. Now we can rationalize it and we can separate the real and imaginary part. And now this side, what is your e to the power iota a t? It is cos of a t plus iota sin a t. Yes, e to the power iota theta is cos theta plus iota sin theta.
Yes, ma'am.
Now you take Laplace. Now since Laplace satisfies the linearity property, you can separate these two. And iota you can take outside. So what will you have? This is equal to this plus iota this. Now compare both sides. What will be the Laplace of cos of a t? कंपेयर करो दोनों तरफ क्या आएगा लैप्लास ऑफ कॉस ऑफ ए टी
हम s / s² + a²
यस दैट इज द रियल पार्ट एंड व्हाट इज द लैप्लास ऑफ साइन ऑफ ए टी
a / s² + a²
यस सो दैट इज द इमेजिनरी पार्ट सो दिस इज द डेरिवेशन हाउ टू फाइंड लैप्लास ऑफ कॉस 18 एंड साइन 80
नो डाउट फार्मूला से नहीं निकल सकता था
निकल सकता है बट वो इंटीग्रेशन मुश्किल होगा थोड़ा ये आ गया ना आपके पास ओके तो दैट्स व्हाई हम इससे कर लेते हैं दिस इज इजी वन बिकॉज इसका हमें पता है लैप्लास ओके क्लियर है बच्चे सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग दैट लैप्लास ऑफ कोस ऑफ 80 इज s / s² + a² एंड लैप्लास ऑफ साइन ऑफ 80 इज a / s² + a² ओके सो यूजिंग दीस फार्मूलास Now tell me what is the Laplace transform of cos of 4t?
S / s² + 16.
So this comes out to be s / s² + 4 square. So that is s / s² + 16. Similarly, you can find out the Laplace transform of sine square t. Now, you can write sine square t as what? One minus cos 2t by t by 2. ये लिख सकते हो? Sine square t. You can write this as 1 minus cos 2t by 2. Now you can separate. You can apply the linearity property. Now what is the Laplace of 1? What is the... Bolo bolo.
1 by...
Very good. And what is the Laplace of cos of 2t?
S / s²
+ 4.
So this will be the Laplace transform of sin square t. Right? यहाँ पे जो हमें formulas given हैं, वो linear power के हैं. तो अगर ये powers में होता है, you have to apply some another thing. Right? तो write down in the terms of multiples of theta, not in the powers of theta. उस फॉर्म में लिखा सिंप्लीफाई किया एंड यू गेट द आंसर सो दिस इज द लैप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ साइन स्क्वायर
यस मैम
नेक्स्ट कर लूं नाउ जस्ट सी द नेक्स्ट स्टैंडर्ड फंक्शन दैट इज कोस हाइपरबोलिक 80 और साइन hyperbolic 80 now what is the laplace transform of this since we know that cos hyperbolic theta is e to the power theta plus e to the power minus theta by 2 and sin hyperbolic theta is e to the power theta minus e to the power minus theta by 2 so we will use these formulas to find out the laplace transform of cos hyperbolic 80 and sin hyperbolic 80 now this is what this is e to the power 80 plus e to the power minus 80 by 2 right now what will be, and you can separate this by linearity property, you get the Laplace transform of e to the power at plus Laplace transform of e to the power minus at. Now what is the Laplace transform of e to the power at? What is this? Abhi humne kiya hai?
1 upon s minus a.
Yes, it is 1 upon s minus a. Similarly over here it will be a ki jagah aapko minus a karna hai. So now you can take the LCM and you can simplify this. So this is s upon s square minus a square. So the Laplace transform of cos of hyperbolic at is s upon s square minus a square. और अगर cos hyperbolic नहीं होता, cos होता, then this is s upon s square plus a square. ये अभी हमने देखा. Sorry. This. अगर cos at है, then this is s upon s square plus a square. और अगर hyperbolic है, then this is s upon s square minus a square. Similarly, you can find out the Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic at. So that will be what? यहाँ पे minus आ जाएगा बीच में. Because formula में minus है. So when you simplify this, what will you get? So a upon s square minus a square. Right, so Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic at, this is a upon s square minus a square. Same way में करना है जैसे आपने cos hyperbolic at का किया. You put the formula for sine hyperbolic at, that is e to the power at minus e to the power minus at by 2. So यहाँ पर minus आ जाएगा, यहाँ minus आ जाएगा, यहाँ minus आ जाएगा, and so on. So you have this. Right? क्लियर है यहाँ तक?
Yes,
sir. So now just see the Laplace transform of standard functions are. So you use these formulas directly to find out the Laplace transform of functions. The Laplace transform of 1 is 1 over s t 1 upon s square t to the power n is n factorial upon s to the power n plus 1 e to the power at is 1 upon s minus a, cos of at is s upon s square plus a square, sine of at is a upon s square plus a square. Laplace of cos hyperbolic at is s upon s square minus a square, and Laplace of sine hyperbolic at is a upon s square minus a square. The same way you can find out Laplace inverse. Agar aapko fs given hai, maan lo fs given hai 1 upon s square, then what will the Laplace inverse of? So that means we have to find ft. Ft kya hoga? Ye kiska inverse hai? T ka. Laplace kiska tha ye? T ka. So this Laplace transform is an operator, right? So ft will be equal to Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square. So agar Laplace inverse puche, inverse of Laplace transform will be what? It will be ft. To hume ye dekhne, ye kiska Laplace transform tha? So 1 over s square hai aapka Laplace transform t ka, right? To ye aagaya aapke paas t. So in this way, inverse operator exists. Clear?
Yes.
So now find Laplace inverse of 4 upon s square plus 9. क्या आएगा बताओ? एस स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर किसका लैपलास होता है?
ए की पावर
नो, एस स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर किसमें आता है? अभी स्टैंडर्ड फंक्शंस की हमने दो में आता है इनमें.
Yes,
एक में एस ऊपर होना चाहिए, एक में कांस्टेंट ऊपर होना चाहिए. तो उसमें एस ऊपर नहीं है, राइट? कांस्टेंट हमने बनाना है. अब देखो ये ए कितना बना यहाँ से, थ्री स्क्वायर, है ना, ए थ्री बना, जबकि ऊपर मेरे पास थ्री नहीं है, राइट? तो हम क्या करेंगे, इसको थ्री से मल्टीप्लाई और थ्री से डिवाइड कर देंगे. तो फोर बाय थ्री जो है मेरा कॉन्स्टेंट हो गया, विच कैन टेकन आउटसाइड. Now, what is the inverse of this Laplace transform? कौन सा function का है?
Sine 3t.
Sine of 3t, right? So in this way we can find out the Laplace inverse. Okay, back जाना है आपने. तो आपको देखना पड़ेगा किस function का ये Laplace transform था. Now, what is the Laplace inverse of 1 upon s to the power 4? ये बताओ. अब s टू द पावर 4 का मतलब फंक्शन कौन सा होगा? t की पावर n में हमें s की पावर n प्लस 1 मिलता है, यानी n कितना आया यहाँ से?
3 फैक्टोरियल.
3 यानी t क्यूब, बट ऊपर हमें कितना चाहिए? 3 फैक्टोरियल. हम क्या करेंगे, 3 फैक्टोरियल से मल्टीप्लाई और डिवाइड. नाउ वी कैन टेक 1 ओवर 3 फैक्टोरियल टू आउटसाइड. And this is Laplace inverse of t cube. So this is the function whose Laplace transform is this one.